Hello students, today our topic is assessment of firm in business taxation for BCom and many other courses we have assessment of firm. So before understanding the taxability of the firm, we should understand what is a firm. See, as per the Partnership Act, Section 4 of Partnership Act of 1932, partnership defined as the relationship between persons who have agreed to share the profits of business carried on by all or any one of them acting for all. See, this definition already we have studied, we understood, but again I am repeating it just because of brushing up what is a firm. See, a firm is nothing but relationship between the persons, relationship between two or more persons who have agreed to share the profits of a business, who agree to do some business and share the profits according to their agreed proportion. And these partners who agreed upon doing some business, who share profits or losses, who can, all the partners can do the business or any one partner can do business acting for all. See, this is what the definition of partnership firm. Now, let us understand what are the characteristic features of a partnership firm or a firm. The persons who agree to do business are called as partners. See, overall, coming together to do business, all such persons are called as partners. All persons are called as partners. Suppose if three partners A, B and C are agreed to do some business in a partnership firm, then these A, B and C becomes partners in the partnership firm. And collectively, all three collectively, they are called as a firm. Understood? Now, they are abiding by a deed called as partnership deed. See, these partners who are agreed to do business, who share the profits or losses, they are abiding, they are agreeing with an agreement called as a partnership agreement or also called as a partnership deed. In this partnership deed, all the partners will be agreeing upon certain rules and regulations and conditions of doing the business. So, we will discuss what are the conditions or what are the different clauses, what are the different points that would be mentioned in the partnership deed in the next points. See, the taxation, the scheme of taxation of the firm. See, what is the scheme of taxation of a firm? The firm is taxed as a separate entity from its partners. See, that means when you are assessing as a partnership firm, when you are going for a taxation or an assessment as a partnership firm, the firm is treated as a separate legal entity from its partners. Means partners are different and partnership firm is different. The firm is different from the partners. Whatever the profits which are earned by the firm, on such profits, the Income Tax Act of 1961 levy the taxes, not on the partners. So, second point is, the definition of firm includes a limited liability partnership and LLP, that is limited liability partnership, is treated as a firm. See, earlier, we had a partnership with unlimited liability. The partner's liability was unlimited. What is unlimited liability in case of partners is, in case if the company suffer with the losses, the partners have to contribute from sell their personal properties and they used to cover with the business losses or the firm losses. So, the liability was unlimited. Say, for example, if an ex-partner introduced 1 lakh rupees and if the firm is suffering with the losses and all his liability was recovered for the losses,
and still some more amount of losses is there, liability is there, then partner have to sell his personal property and pay off the liability of the partnership firm. This was the earlier case. Now there is a new type of a partnership called as limited liability partnership, where the partner's liability is limited to the extent of the capital which the partners have contributed. So there is no need of selling the personal properties, no need of recovery of the personal properties of the partners. That is what the limited liability partnership, even limited liability partnership is treated as a firm. Share of partners in the income of the firm is exempted. See, the share of income of the partners is exempted. Why? Because if A, B and C, these three partners collectively, if they are doing any business and if they earn any profit, if the firm earns any profit, then the taxation, the tax will be levied on the profits earned by the firm. After paying the taxes by the firm, the remaining profit will be distributed to the partners. Or such share of partners' income is exempted because already the firm's profit, whatever the profits earned by the firm, on such profits tax has been paid. So therefore, share of profits in the partnership firm or share of profits of the partnership firm is exempted in case of in the hands of partners. Next is salary, bonus or commission or any type of remuneration which is paid or payable to the partners is allowed as a deduction and is allowed as a deduction in the partnership firm or in the firm. That means to say they can deduct, they can debit to their profit and loss account and they can reduce their profits in case if partners have paid any salary, bonus, commission or any type of remuneration. If it is paid, it is allowable or deductible in their profits, provided, but there is a condition. I will explain to you the condition, provided with some restrictions under Income Tax Act of 1961. Say you cannot pay as whatever the amount of salary, bonus, commission to the partners. There are certain restrictions, there are certain provisions, and we need to understand such provision, which I will explain to you further. Next is interest on capital of partners is subjected up to 12% per annum. See, if the partners have contributed their capital and if the firm is paid, if the firm is paid any interest on capitals of the partners, which is allowed as a deduction up to 12% per annum, up to 12% per annum. In case if it is more than 12% per annum, such interest on capital is not allowed, is disallowed in the partnership firm. Got it? See, these are the scheme of taxation of the firms. Now, let us understand what are the conditions to be fulfilled for an assessment of firm. See, the conditions for assessment of firm, it is clearly given under section 184 of Income Tax Act of 1961, which governs the taxation and assessment of the firm with certain conditions. What are the such conditions? There must be partnership deed. See now, what is partnership deed? It is nothing but an agreement between the partners who agreed upon to do business, who mentioned, who have agreed on all the rules and regulations and terms and conditions. All such terms and conditions has to be mentioned in the agreement and duly signed by all the partners. If such partnership deed is agreed, then we can go ahead with the assessment of firm in case of taxation as well as assessment. Sir, you may ask a question, sir, what happens if there is no partnership deed in the partnership firm? Then under section, it will not cover under 184, it covers under 185. So then the treatment of taxation and assessment will be in a different criteria. Now assume that if the partnership deed is existing and if there is an evidence of partnership deed, then they can go for assessment of firms. Next, deed should be in writing. See, partnership deed should be in writing. It should not be by conduct of the partners. It should not be by oral. See, oral partnership deed or by showing some action or conduct, we cannot take it as a partnership deed. So partnership deed must be exist in the partner firm, and also it should be in writing. And deed should contain all conditions of all partners. See, all the partners, before they commence their business, they should have a partnership deed in writing, and they should put all their rules and regulations and terms and conditions, and which are duly signed, agreeing and signed by all the partners. Then only we can go for taxation and assessment of firm. All of you got it? Now let me tell you what are the different clauses which were there in the partnership deed. See, first is name clause. What is the name of the partnership firm and place of the partnership firm, whether it is registered or unregistered, and what is the capital that each partners are contributing towards the partnership firm, and what is, if any partner is working as a working partner, how much remuneration should be payable to the partners, and credit terms of the partnership deed. What is the drawings capacity or drawing ability, capacity of the each partner? What is the profit sharing ratio? And what are the objectives of the partnership firm? What is the nature of the firm? See, like various, all these type of, okay, what is the interest on capital? Okay, what is the rate of interest which is calculated as a interest on capital? All these terms and rules and regulations must be included in the partnership deed, and all the partners should duly agreed and signed on such agreement or partnership deed, then only the such firms can go for taxation and assessment of firms. Now we understood so many aspects, legal aspects as per Income Tax Act of 1961 as well as Partnership Act of 1932. Now let us understand what is the tax provisions while filing the income tax return of a partnership firm. Now guys, we have to understand some of the provisions under Income Tax Act of 1961. As I told you, in case of scheme of taxation, see, partner's remuneration, that is salary, bonus, commission, is allowable as a deduction, and interest on capital is as allowed up to 12% per annum. Now on what conditions these salaries, remuneration or bonus, commission to the partners is allowable, and how much interest on capital is allowable, and when it is allowable. See, under section 184 of Income Tax Act of 1932, okay, the Income Tax Act is clearly says you provide remuneration to the partners, you provide remuneration to the partners under section 141 subsection 1 subclause 1, provided if there is a partnership deed. If there is a partnership deed, and the partners should be working partners. See, there must be a partnership deed. There must be a partnership deed. And when you are providing remuneration to the partners, all such partners should be working partners.
means no partner should be a sleeping partner. Partner should be a working partner. If a partner is working, then you are allowable or you can provide remuneration to such working partners in the form of salary, bonus and commission. And if the deed is not, if the partnership deed is not mentioned anything about the remuneration, then you cannot provide or you cannot allow as such salaries or remuneration to the partners in the profit and loss account of the firm. So, if the partnership deed, in the partnership deed, if there is a condition, if there is a clause that partners are eligible to get remuneration as a working partner, you can provide for or you can give a deduction for partners' remuneration. Even then also there is certain legal conditions. Okay, this is the first one. The second one is interest on capital. See, this is regarding remuneration of the partners. Remuneration of partners. In case of interest on capital, interest on capital. See, when as per the Income Tax Act, if the firm is under 184, who are having a partnership deed, who are registered and in writing and agreed upon all the partners, if these conditions are fulfilled, the interest on capital of the partners is allowable as a deduction up to 12%. Up to 12% per annum. Only when if the partnership deed is having a clause of interest on capital up to 12% per annum. Even in the partnership deed, you may have 15% also, 20% also. But we provide only 12% per annum as interest on capital of the partners. If there is no partnership deed, then there is no remuneration of partners is allowable and also no interest on capital will be allowed. Now, let us see under section 184, 1 subsection A of 40B, okay, clause 40B, what it says, it has got certain restrictions for remuneration. There are some rules for providing partners remuneration. Now, let me tell you what is the rule. Partners remuneration. See, if the partner is a working partner, then the partner's remuneration is allowable as a deduction. Number one. Secondly, the partner should be a working partner. Then only we will give deduction. But under section 40B, there are certain conditions, there are certain limitations. What is that limitation is? We'll take first one as, what is the actual remuneration? Actual remuneration to the partners, how much you are providing? Okay, with this, we compare 1,50,000 rupees. 1,50,000 rupees if book profit is negative. What is book profit means? The profits of the firm. Okay, profits of the firm after adjusting all the adjustments, whatever the profit we get, that profit is called as a book profit. If such book profit is a negative, that is a loss, then we can provide 1,50,000 rupees, 1,50,000 rupees or actual remuneration. Okay, I will write it in a different way. If book profit is negative, then we compare 1,50,000 or actual remuneration. In this, whichever is higher as allowable partners remuneration under section 40B. Got it? So what happens if there is a profit, there is a positive amount in the book profit. If there is a positive in the book profit, then we will write actual remuneration. Actual remuneration. If book profit is 3 lakh rupees, book profit is 3 lakh rupees, then 1 lakh 50 or 90% of book profit. See, on 3 lakh rupees, 90% would be 2 lakh 70 thousand rupees. Now we compare 1 lakh 50 or 2 lakh 70. In this, whichever is higher, will be compared with the actual remuneration, and actual remuneration and the higher of these two will be taken here. In this, whichever is lower is taxable. I mean to say, will be deductible under the book profit. Means partner's remuneration is allowed as a deduction by comparing like this. Sir, what happens if the book profit is more than 3 lakh rupees? If the book profit is more than 3 lakh rupees, then the calculation part will be in a different way. What happens then is, if book profit is more than 3 lakh rupees, then we'll take the actual remuneration. Actual remuneration, or we can we can write on first 3 lakh rupees, we take 90% on the balance. On the balance, we calculate 60%. See, in my example. Say, for example, if the book profit is 5 lakh rupees, on first 3 lakhs, it will be 2 lakh 70,000 rupees. On 5 lakhs, 3 lakhs is 2 lakh 70, 90%. On the balance amount, 5 lakh minus 3 lakh, 2 lakh rupees, on that 60% will be 1 lakh 20. So, totally 3 lakh 90,000 rupees. Will be compared with the actual remuneration. Say, for example, if the actual remuneration is given as 3 lakh rupees, in these two, whichever is lower will be given as a deduction for the book profit in calculating the profits from the firm's business. So 3 lakhs or 3 lakh 90, whichever it will be lower. See guys, mostly they'll ask a 6 marks question based on the partner's remuneration only. So in case of negative, we have seen actual remuneration or 1 lakh 50,000 rupees, whichever is higher will be taken as a partner's deduction for partnership, partner's remuneration. What happens if with the book profit is exactly 3 lakh rupees, then we compare 1 lakh rupees, 1 lakh 50 or 90% of the 3 lakhs. So 90% of the 3 lakhs will be 2 lakh 70,000. So now the higher 1 lakh 50 or 2 lakh 70, whichever is higher, 2 lakh 70 will be higher. So we compare with the actual remuneration. Actual remuneration or 2 lakh 70, whichever is lower will be given as a deduction as a partner's remuneration under section 184(1) and 40B. Got it, guys? So this is about partnership, partner's remuneration deduction. So this is a condition. So when we provide all these things, I will explain to you in the next video.